Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we continue the FL Studio series right here at BusyWorksBeats.com/FL Studio. We're also going to combine this with the music theory series as well. So again, today if you get lost, no worries. You're going to get the project files below. Just go to BusyWorksBeats.com/FL Studio. Be sure to confirm your email after you sign up so that you get to the download page. So today we're going to create a track from the beginning. I'm going to guide you through the process of creating a track. So let's open up your channel rack, which is this icon. All right, we're gonna right click. Let's replace this with FL keys. Now people sleep on this, and this is a piano you can even use for like Blueface style. Let me turn up my headphones a little bit. All right, there we go. All right, so I'm using a MIDI controller, but I'm gonna assume you don't have a MIDI controller. So the first thing we're gonna do, we're gonna try and focus on the trap genre today, but we're gonna move into different genres over time because different genres have different skill sets and different genres have different instruments that don't sound realistic all the time using a computer. So anyway, let's close out the browser. We're gonna open up the piano roll and let's start at D, which is this note here. We're gonna drag it out for a bar. Now, my snap to grid, I usually keep it at a half beat, just so it's in the right chunks, okay? Then we're gonna add another D, then another D in a higher octave. And the chord we're gonna start off with is a D minor chord, which is D, F, A. All right, now instead of playing this long drawn out chord, we're gonna drag the note back so it just hits on the beginning and then it dies out. Let's turn on the metronome. So here's where we're going to start to begin our melody, the top note of this chord. We're going to start at A and create a melody. So in short, for the people who are a little more advanced, we're going to be playing a chord using the top note only, but spreading it out. So we're going to play A, C, E, G, which is A minor 7. And I'm just switching the voicing. So instead of going up here, or you could add both notes. It sounds pretty cool. Also, it emphasizes, it makes this like an accent area. So the mistake a lot of people make in the beginning is not creating enough pauses, enough rests. Also velocity. I'm not going to get into velocity and all this stuff yet because I don't want to confuse you. So just draw in the notes as we go. But we're going to leave a gap here. So what I'm doing here is just going from, imagine this, three notes in a row. I'm skipping one note, going to the note below it, actually skipping two notes in this case, going to the note below it, and then I'm going back up to the note right below the top note. You don't really have to, it's not a formula. I'm just listening to my brain, I'm just breaking it down for you. So we're skipping two notes, going back up to the note, going to the note below it in the scale, then going to the note below that note in the scale, which would be D, then going to the note, two notes below this one in the scale. I think two notes, yeah, one, two. And then the pattern continues. Now I'm being honest, this is just a melody that came from my head. There's no magical thing about it here. But let's add some magic to it. So here we're going to add two notes at a time. It's called harmonizing your melody. That's what people don't do. Another thing people don't do is support their melody with chords. So let's find an area where we want to accent. So this is the first accent area, second accent area, and other two. So think of these accent, the red points or pink points, as your drums. So boom, 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 boom. Okay, so I want an accent, boom, boom, boom. I want an accent right here. So it's just an octave, which is the same note. So boom, 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 boom. So I'm treating these notes as if they're kicks. Okay, so that's why melody draws heavily from rhythm when it comes to drums, but also it comes from chords as well, because that's what makes melody sound good relatively. let's say, so in this case, I'm not considering these like a kick drum, more like a snare roll if these were drums. It's at a G. This is a chord, EGB. It's just an inverted fifth, it's called. I don't like the chord, it sounds kind of... what note we had. What note did I add? I don't remember. Definitely, let me go back. Oh, I added G. So now without the metronome, it carries its own rhythm. Now if we added velocity, which is are these bars down here. So every time these notes hit, these accent points, I'm going to leave the volume up. For everywhere else, I'm going to pull it up now just so I could see it. And then for every other area, I'm going to, I also forgot to add bass octaves here, which are going to be the same note and octave lower. Now it's a little bit stronger. Now your thing sounds like way more complex, and all we're doing is doing little things to it. Now technically I play chords here, so in this case the melody starts at the top note of the chord, so I'm going to assume that G is the top note of the chord. I'm going to assume that we're using all the white notes. You don't have to memorize this stuff. Now in this case G was my bass note. Let's hear what it... I'm not trying to complicate it because I know you're just starting. So if I start talking music theory in these, I'm just gonna shut up. Because this stuff is simple. I don't want you to overlap knowledge. So let's make these chords instead of just a bass note. Okay, so that's all I'm doing. I'm making sure that this note is the top note of some chord. I didn't go over chords and scales and all that, so don't jump ahead, okay? And the reason I keep harping on that is because people, when they're first learning, they try to like jump way ahead of themselves, and that's why you get so confused, because you're trying to do level 13 stuff in the beginning and you're just not that advanced. You're just going to make yourself more frustrated. So anyway, just copy the notes. Don't worry about why I'm doing it just yet, because you're not that far. But for the people who are far, I'm just continuing my approach to the reason why I created this chord here and I started the melody. This was the top note, and I built a chord under it. Doing the same thing here. This is the top note, building a chord under it. That's all I'm doing. I'm just gonna invert this note so it has a little more of a lift to it. Also, I have to lift that bottom bass. Still sounds a little... For my ear, I want to hear a G again. So in this case, I'm going to leave room for G. I don't want to play the F near G. This is for the music theory needs people, okay? For beginners, do not worry about what I'm talking about. I'm just adding a G here, but if I pull this F down, it would be too close and it would sound too muddy in this octave. So now I'm going to use some music theory and ease to finish this out. But before I do that, I'm going to add velocity changes. It's almost like too much velocity dynamic. That's why I said don't get obsessed about this stuff. But I do like the harsh velocity on the chord. I feel like it needs some resolution, so again, there's a lot. Let me just be honest with you. Melody is a lot more than just learning how to make a melody. Melody, you have to know chords, you have to know scales, modes, you have to learn music theory basics like scale degrees, how to, you know, relative systems, chord codes. We teach this all in Music Theory Essentials at BusyWorksBeats.com. slash music theory, but melody magic was the third course in our music theory course. But people want to jump straight to melody without learning scales, without learning chords, and you wonder why you're confused when it comes to melody. It's because melody is everything combined. It's not just one thing. It's not just scales. It's not just, you know, there's a lot to it. So I'm trying to make this as beginner friendly as possible, but in reality, to explain every little decision I'm making takes those two courses before. So what I'm doing now is resolving this energy into the next chord. I don't want it to be a D minor. Boom. Let's copy the chord. It does sound good on D minor, but I want the bass to change. So I'm just going to move the, I'm going to transpose these chords and fix them as we go. Now the chord, this part, if I just move it, it doesn't sound good all the time. So I'm going to fix it if it gets out of key. Again, that goes back to music theory in a day. You have to learn about scales and scale degrees. So what I'm going to do is let my ear guide me through. My ear wants to hear this bass change. It wants to go upward this time. That's what my ear wants to hear. Dun, 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 dun. Okay, so now I'm going to figure out the chord for that bass line. So it works for melody and bass. Now we're harmonizing the melody. We're adding a chord to it, even though this is a bass, technically. But it shows how deep melody extends. It goes into chords as well. So again, this is the root note. I don't like this B note. And I don't like the A on that D. So what I might do is change the chord. And these are the top notes of the chord. Okay, so we're not worried about the bass. In music theory, you can have a chord like A minor, but you can play a completely different bass note like C. So it doesn't always have to be A as your bass. What I'm doing is reverse engineering these chords. Again, from the Music Theory Essentials course package, we show you how to do this. These chords sound out of place, and I'm trying to figure out what my ear wants to hear. I think it just wants to hear octaves and not a chord. Okay, that's probably what it was. So again, melody is deep. It's way bigger than just a scale. It's EQ. Then we'll move into the second portion where we're gonna add drums. Add some reverb, fruity reverb too. Cut out some lows here. If you want to get fancy, you can add gross beat here. And you could try halftime. It's a lot of notes, and there's some deep notes. So let's go to momentary. Let's go to half speed. Add the EQ after everything. Let's pull back the time meter here. See how it's complicated? I do like the slowed down sound. It sounds a little more emotional because it's stretching the audio. Let's pull everything up an octave, control up. So we can have less clutter in the bass frequencies and growth speed. So all that work just to get a simple sound like this, but it sounds cool though. You could also try reverse. So you can add another gross beat, go to presets, momentary, and go to reverse. Now it's gonna take a bar to hear it in reverse. Reminds me of a Drake sound. So let's open up Edison because I really like that tone. Let's go to record on play, hit record, and remember it takes a bar for gross beat to reverse. So it's gonna take a bar, then we're gonna have to record an extra bar. Whoops. Hit play. Let's do it this way. What I'm gonna do, I should have left a gap here. So it records, so notice this gap, okay? The time markers are off because of the effect. So let's go to new, record on play. I should have recorded that last little bit where it went, because the reverb was reversing. Let's send it to playlist. And what we're gonna do is grab the slip tool, hit Alt, left click, and drag, and line it up manually. Mute the MIDI track, go to song mode, hit spacebar or play. And make sure that, go to your channel rack. Make sure this is routed to a different mixer channel so it doesn't go through the same effects. So now we gotta line up the timing here. I'll do it for you. Hit Alt, left click. So now we have a Drake sound, all from a stock plugin, and you might have overlooked just because you didn't know how to make it sound good. So I like the sound. Let's move into the part two where we add the drums. Thanks for watching. If you want to continue the series, go to busyworksbeats.com/FL Studio. That's where you're also going to get these project files for free. So again, click that link below or go to busyworksbeats.com/FL Studio. When you sign up with your email, be sure to confirm your email so that you get to the downloads page. Thanks for watching today. It's busyworksbeats.com.